Hey guys, thanks for checking out the podcast. Before we get started, I want to remind you about the very cool bucket list trip I am doing in 2026, the Smitty Learns Irish podcast, where I'm going to do my bucket list, hike Ireland for a year, learn about Irish history, town by town, through the mouths of the pub owners and regulars. Because what's a better way to learn about something you love than to experience it yourself? Patreon.com/we3smiths, only $3 a month, and thanks for checking it out. Hello and welcome to The Rock Raider. My name is Smitty from the What the Hell Everything podcast, reacting for the very first time, very first listen to the band Lonely the Brave. If you're not familiar with The Rock Raider, my intent is to find my next favorite rock and metal bands. I'm very well versed in the world of rock and roll, but I'm always finding stuff that I never heard about, opening my rock and roll minds and making myself listen to stuff I've never listened to before, even though I know I should have. And I've never heard of Lonely the Brave before. This is by request. Who requested this? MCVB5726. That's who. I have heard of Ween. This was on a Ween reaction that I did. I have heard of Ween, but never listened to them. Really like this. Hey, love your Biffy Clyro videos as well. Check out a band called Lonely the Brave, either Backroads and the Blue. Or excuse me, Backroads or the Blue, the Green. And I'm going with the Blue, the Green, which is from The Day's War. I do believe their debut album from 2014. They are a British alternative rock band. That's how they're described in the Wikipedias. And I know there's a video for this song. I am, a lot of times, my first listen to a band, I try to just have it be audio only because that's how I want to fall in love with a band. You know, a lot of times videos are distracting for me. I just want to react to music the way I listen to it, which is with headphones on, just fucking jamming. So, let's do it. Lonely the Brave, the Blue, the Green. Very Foo Fighter reminiscent guitars. Real melodic, it's nice. Like I said, it's very reminiscent of some Foo Fighters guitar to me. That's my take on just how that sounds right off the top of my head. The vocals are striking. I only know how to describe it like this. There's like a hint of like a modern vocal delivery, not emo necessarily, but there's a very especially when you get into the alternative rock, there is a similar delivery, at least to me, in this era of alternative rock, or this generation of alternative rock is probably the best way to put it. But there's a tinge of like striking. It hit me that there was also just this tinge of like bluesy grittiness to it. And I thought first impressions are key. Now I will shut up. Enjoy it some more. Let's start it from the beginning, shall we?
Black mark where your heart should have been.
I can hear the Britishness in it, and I enjoy that. You know, there's a lot of times where bands from Great Britain will sing essentially in an American English accent, and I know that's a conscious decision by a lot of bands to do that. So I always like to hear the native inflections and accents in the music. You know what I mean? There, I said it. So carry me out to the garden so I can breathe it in, 'cause I'm in trouble again. Oh, carry me out to the garden so I can't stop the end, 'cause I'm in trouble. I like really, really like how those ramping up sort of guitars are sounding right now. There wasn't a lot about necessarily the riffs or anything like that that really stuck out to me. But right now, it just feels like it's ramping up for something cool. And the tone that that they're playing with really makes it stick out to me. Bring that back just a little bit. So I can feel it inside. Sounds like Gavin Rossdale a little bit, too. You know, a little bit. Reminds me of Gavin Rossdale. I'm like, God, it sounds like Bush almost. Sometimes this happens where I just forget what thought I'm in, you guys, and we just fucking move on, and it might come back to me. I'm enjoying the song. Now I remember what I was going to say. I really like what they're doing here. It's really fucking cool drum fills. I'm catching a lot of bass. And that guitar, just whatever fucking they're doing right there. Really do a good job of explaining myself sometimes. Let's continue. We'll be right back. See, yeah, I appreciated that. Sometimes I just break in a 20s gangster voice. I apologize. It just happens. I did enjoy that. I just thought it was some cool layering going on. I dug the voice a lot. I dug the lyrics. So, yeah, I enjoyed that, you guys. I, again, first listen to Lonely the Brave, and shan't be my last, I don't think. You got a suggestion for that band? I know Backwoods or Background, perhaps Backwoods. That was another one I might check out. But hey, feel free to throw that suggestion in the comment section. Also, really appreciate any liking, subscribing. You dig the videos, man. I got a lot of them. You dig just weird-ass, goofy content and hopefully thoughtful and funny sometimes. I got all kinds of that stuff, too. What the Hell Everything Podcast, that's on Patreon. Patreon also where I'm going down rabbit holes for bands, man. B-sides, deep stuff, full live albums, you fucking name it, man. All going down at Patreon. So it's only $3 a month, too. Hey, I appreciate you. Thanks for joining me, and until next time.
What the hell, everything?